Hi, I'm Dr. Ron Miller, and this is Dr. Trey Martin of Pursuit Physiotherapy. And today we're going to talk specifically about front shoulder pain and having that annoying bicep pain with baseball or softball athletes. So anyone that really does an overhead throwing motion, but specifically not just all shoulder injuries. You can find plenty of information about what types of shoulder injuries in overhead athletes, but we want to talk specifically about that anterior or that front shoulder pain that a lot of throwers get, and then that nagging bicep injury. So off the top of your head, you know, we're gonna have a discussion here about this, but what are some possibilities that could cause this?
So I think the first thing to kind of state is one of the things we know that happens with throwers, an adaptation to throwing, is you see a bony adaptation where the shoulder is going to be set more into retroversion. So that seems like a lot of weird foreign words, but what we're going to see is the position of the bone is going to kind of torque back like you're wringing a towel out a little bit. So what that means is you're going to have more external rotation and less internal rotation. That's normal. That's a normal adaptation in throwers, and it's normally you add 15 degrees of external rotation and you are losing about 15 degrees of internal rotation. The range is still there, the arc is still there, but just your shoulder position itself is different. And with that, we see a lot of times with baseball guys is the front of their shoulder capsule is a little bit more lax than the back side of it. So when you go back in your throwing motion, the head of the humerus comes forward and we have a little bit more anterior capsule space. So we're going to see with that, we're going to see stress on structures in the acromial space, but also in like the biceps tendon. So a couple things that are just basic baseline causes of this pain that can creep anywhere through here is we're going to see overload of the long head of the biceps. That's going to be one for me. A second one too is just a general labral pathology. Another common cause too is something called posterior impingement, and then we can also see a regular type of impingement. So if you can just break down a few of those topics for us and kind of what common things you see with that.
Yeah, I think those are definitely four options, right? And even five if you just add in general biomechanics. We see a lot of people who, you know, come up negative on rotator cuff tear testing, labral tear testing, but they still have this annoying anterior shoulder pain. Just having bad mechanics can overload that structure. You may not have a diagnosis, but these are the people who you just treat the thoracic spine or the hip, and then their shoulder pain goes away. So, you know, there's almost five things right there that you just mentioned. I feel that, you know, sometimes with throwers, you can have a trigger point in your rotator cuff muscles in the back that I've touched before and like, oh, I can feel that shooting pain right here. So you can have an active trigger point that is referring pain to the front of the shoulder area that's causing your shoulder pain. Again, throwers, overhead athletes, you need to, you're overloading those external rotators in the rotator cuff. So from overtraining a weak muscle, you can develop a trigger point. So I think a trigger point can also cause that front shoulder pain. And some athletes, you know, for like a sixth or seventh option, in athletes who I feel had a prior injury of either shoulder, thoracic outlet, first rib, or even neck, you can develop some neural tension. And the, you know, that's just a fancy word for like a tight nerve. But normally this is only in patients who had a prior injury of either neck, shoulder, or something like that, that the nerves get tight, and then all of a sudden you're like going to throw again, and now you have this pain that's kind of like shooting right here, and sometimes it even goes to the forearm and like wrist and hand. So having neural tension from a prior injury is also something that I've seen before. But overall, I think those five that you like listed, you know, very rarely do I see a rotator cuff tear refer pain there. It's more labral pathology, as you said, and general impingement can also refer there, but you also see this lateral diffuse ache in the side of the shoulder. That's kind of a textbook sign of more impingement, but I have seen it here. To get more specific, so there's three muscles that actually attach here. One of your rotator cuff muscles, which is your subscapularis, your pec major attaches there, and then your lat dorsi muscle attaches there. And a lot of times with like overhead athletes, your lats are tight, especially being a post-op patient. If you're recovering from like a labral repair or even a rotator cuff repair, your lats tight. So sometimes, again, you come up negative on my special test for all the major stuff, but you still have pain here. And you can do a myofascial release to some of those muscles, and it fixes the front shoulder pain that way. So we kind of gave them eight possibilities there of what could be causing anterior or front shoulder pain with this.
So I think, too, a lot of the commonalities you see between all of these, because we just gave you a lot of anatomical reasons, but one of the easiest ways to alleviate these issues is we see a lot of guys, he's mentioning like your subscap and your lat, we see a lot of people with a lot of tension in their armpit area. So that comes pretty naturally when you're training a lot, you're throwing a lot, your lats and your subscap are going to tighten up, and those are going to restrict your throwing motion. So the lat and the subscap are going to be internal rotators of the arms. They're going to help with this motion, but to throw, you got to get back here first. So if you don't have full external rotation, you don't have good overhead range of motion, a lot of times the shoulder gets picked on from that. And I think too, the concept you were talking about neural tension, something that when I was playing in college, a lot of guys would talk about pain. You can see, especially the ulnar nerve, for me personally, I don't know, I would say ulnar and median are probably most common with this. And you'll feel a pain where it can either go stay kind of localized in your bicep, but for me, I would have it all the way down through my elbow into my pinky, and it would feel kind of like a electric type pain where it's like almost stinging and stuff like that. And it's interesting, if we were going to put the ulnar nerve an ulnar nerve tension test, it would look kind of in this motion here, which as kids, yeah, the favorite way to do it was a little eye thing like that. So if you think about kind of the throwing motion, we're putting a lot of strain on the ulnar nerve there. So that can be a common complaint too, of even medial elbow pain all the way down the chain. It's pretty close to the UCL too, so a lot of stress is going on in that area. But fixes is just really maintaining full overhead range of motion and soft tissue quality. And then from there, kind of the 1A and 1B of that, if you have good soft tissue quality, and you also need an equivalent level of external rotator cuff strength. So if we can strengthen these muscles quite a bit, and then also strengthen the muscles too in our bicep and then our wrist flexors and pronators, that's going to help take a lot of the strain off of these passive structures that are getting beat up during this process. So when I say passive structures, we have two main ways to stabilize things. We have passive structures, those are going to be like ligaments that and our joint capsules and stuff like that. And then we have active structures that can move, so those are going to be our muscles and where they attach to the bone from tendons. So a lot of times, if our active structures are not as weak or not as strong and they're fairly weak, then our passive structures have to take the brunt of the force. And they don't like that very much. So the stronger we can make our active structures and also having good quality range of motion, the less force we impart. Yeah. And then the third part is going to be how much usage you're getting. So if you could be the strongest person in the world, but we can all only withstand so much force. So you could be the strongest guy ever, but if I hit you with my car, it's going to still give you an injury. So same concept, but obviously less drastic. With throwing, if we're throwing a lot, we can have the greatest range of motion and the greatest strength and all of that. That's all good, and that's going to help lessen your injury risk. But we really need to start thinking about how we're managing year-round throwing and also getting smart pitch programming. I've mentioned this before if you've been following us for a while. It's really important to me that you peak at the right time. You don't want to... I liken it to like everyone wants to get in the best shape of their life for their wedding. You want to do that. You want your wedding day to be when the most scouts are in tow. So you want to peak for that. You want to be strengthened, trained, ready to go so you can show the most velocity with the scouts in the stands. So that's going to be crucial too, is really planning out your season based off of when do I want to look my best. So all those things are to come into a factor. I think load management will be key, but maintaining good quality range of motion and strength are going to be huge, and that's really going to help alleviate a lot of your issues.
Yeah, I think you touched on a lot of points there.
Yeah.
That's great stuff with full range of motion, strengthening, load management, making sure you're not in overload or doing too much too soon. If I had to add in anything there, I would say the key to getting pain-free is to make sure that you have the correct diagnosis. Okay, so as I said earlier, you know, with this front shoulder pain, I don't see a lot of rotator cuff tears presenting as this. So if someone just treats you like, oh, it's a rotator cuff tear, and they start treating you like a rotator cuff tear, but that's not normally the right cause of this or the root cause of why you have your shoulder pain, you're going to be wasting time and wasting money with this stuff because you're not going to get the results. When you solve the root cause of any of those eight reasons that could be causing your pain, if you want results and you want to get pain-free again, you have to solve that first. And that's where we come in. A lot of people can like still try some self-mobility works, do some strengthening. If it works for you and gets you pain-free, great, that's perfect. You don't need to see us for that. But if you find yourself doing some like massages, doing some creams here to try to get it or to try treatments and it's not working and your pain keeps coming back or it's you're not getting results, period, that's the time where you kind of have to call us, get the thorough eval done, solve that root cause, because then after that it's coasting. Because once you solve that problem and understand it, then after that you'll get results fast and then you'll address these other things and get back to throwing pain-free. So anything else that you want to add in to finish up?
I would say just like kind of piggybacking off what he just said, like finding the root cause is huge. Sometimes things will present in a way that you get treated wrong for it. So we've even seen things like surgical operations for things like a subacromial decompression fail and people still have the same issue. So it really is crucial to get the key diagnosis. And it's really hard to self-diagnose. You need somebody to evaluate and take a bunch of objective numbers and figure out where are your suboptimal categories of performance that we can address. And also what's causing this main issue. I mean, that is really paramount with things. It can get tricky when you're trying to self-evaluate, like why my biceps hurt. And you may think, okay, it's just my bicep. I thought for years when I was playing before I had any training as a physical therapist, I thought, wow, my bicep just hurts. And it turned out I wound up getting an MRI and I had a partial rotator cuff tear. And then I also had a case of internal impingement of my shoulder. So I thought the whole time that it was just my bicep, but it turned out it was actually a referring from somewhere else. So there's definitely some concepts where you can get into the weeds in the science here of how things can refer from either the neck or different structures that can mask as something else. And you may think, okay, my pain is here, I need to treat here. And in reality, as I think you touched on earlier a little bit, things like thoracic rotation or maybe your neck or maybe neural tension, there's a lot of times different causes that can masquerade as shoulder pain. And sometimes too, it is actually just straight up shoulder pain, but having a professional diagnosis to really look into those things can really help you get on the path to recovery. And also having a good professional program that can be structured and get you back to throwing pain-free is also huge too, to tackle the load management side of things that I mentioned earlier.
Perfect. So if you're dealing with that front shoulder pain or like overload to your bicep, I hope you enjoyed this video. At least you know all the possibilities right now that could be causing that pain. And then now you also know what is the key and the most important step to getting pain free again and throwing again without dealing with pain. And then we also went over some treatment options of what you have to look for in the treatment. So if you found it, if you have questions for us, you can put them in the comment box below, or you can find us at pursuittherapy.com. I hope you enjoyed this video and hope it helps you guide you to get back to being pain free and for first off to get rid of your shoulder pain. So thank you for watching and we hope you enjoyed it. And if you need to reach us for anything, we are here to help, and visit us at pursuittherapy.com. Thanks.
Thanks, guys.